The Indian Navy said on Friday that a MiG-29K trainer aircraft had crashed in the Arabian Sea around 5 p.m. on Thursday. One pilot was rescued while a search operation was launched for the second pilot, who has been missing since the crash. The crashed MiG-29K was not upgraded like the others in the fleet. The experts have pointed out the serviceability issue of the aircraft. This is the third such crash involving the Navy's Russian-made MiG-29K in a year. In May 2020, another Indian Air Force MiG-29 had crashed during a training mission in the Hoshiarpur district of Punjab. Experts say, only one-third of a fleet of 45 aircraft is operational at one time due to serviceability issues. In India, the MiG-29K is the choice of aircraft for both the aircraft carriers, INS Vikramaditya and an under-construction carrier. The fighter jets are also deployed at two naval air stations, INS Tega at Visakhapatnam on the east coast and INS Hansa at Goa on the west coast, the mainstay of the Indian Navy's air defense fleet. The serviceability issue is also raised against Su-30 MKI. Amid the border standoff with China, the Defense Acquisition Council under the chairmanship of Defense Minister Rajnath Singh had in July accorded approval for the purchase of 21 MiG-29s along with the upgrade of 59 existing MiG-29 aircraft. India and Russia have been negotiating the purchase of MiG-29. The MiG-29 procurement and upgradation of the existing MiG-29 fleet from Russia is estimated to cost ₹7,418 crore. 12 more Su-30 MKI will also be procured from HAL. But the crashes raise serious questions over the acquisition of these fighter jets for ₹7,418 crore. Experts speculate that India may not buy more MiG-29K or even MiG-35 for the IAF. They say the better options for India are Rafale fighter jets or F-18. The MiG-29 is considered one of the world's most prolific fighter jets due to its usage, but over 40 years old aircraft is no match for the French Rafale or other Western counterparts. First inducted in the 1980s, the aircraft was conceived as a low-end, air superiority fighter. One more area where it falls out is that it has a lesser powerful radar as compared to the Rafale, which boasts a multi-directional radar system that can detect 40 targets at the same time in a range of over 100 kilometers. Considering these developments, there is a huge question if India should move towards advanced Western jets or continue with Russian technology. Thank you everyone for watching this video.